By around 18 months of age, infants seem to have a basic understanding that other people might be different from themselves. Repicoli and Gopnik in 1997 showed that infants actually have a basic understanding of other people's desires. In their experiment, Betty Repicoli and Alison Gopnik had two plates placed in front of the infant. One plate had crackers on it, and the other plate had broccoli. The experimenter then sat next to the infant and expressed to the infant that they don't actually like crackers, but preferred broccoli instead. The experimenter would put a piece of cracker in their mouth and say to the infant, "Yuck, crackers," showing their distaste for crackers, and then say, "Yum, broccoli, yum," showing the infant that they didn't like the crackers, but liked the broccoli. Then afterwards, the experimenter placed their hands in the middle of the two plates and asked the infant, "Can I have some, please?" They didn't refer to any specific object, they just asked, "Can I have some?" 18-month-old infants reached out and gave the experimenter their preference. Even if the infant themselves may have preferred the crackers themselves, they gave the broccoli to the experimenter. This suggests that 18-month-old infants have a fundamental understanding that their desires may contradict from other people's desires. The infant's understanding that their own desires can be different from others is also scaffolded by their mother or primary caregiver. I mentioned earlier that mothers talk to their infants about their own desire first. Then, between 18 to 36 months of age, the mother talks to the infant about their thoughts and beliefs because they have a good basic grasp of desire by then. After that, the mother talks about other people's mental states. Instead of saying things like, "You should do this," the mother says things like, "Daniel thinks that the dog is cute." Talking to infants about the thoughts and beliefs of others foster the infant's understanding that the self might be different from others.